possessed, but that the very crowd, James and John, said, do you want us to call heaven and order some fire to come down? I'm talking about James and John. You know, they wanted to be so close to the Lord that they said, look, God, when you come into your kingdom, can one of us sit on the right and the other one sit on the left? That they wanted to be close to the Lord. I said they wanted to be close to the Lord. Y'all ain't got it yet. Can I take a poll in the house this morning? Is there anybody in here that wants to be close to the Lord? If you really want to be close to him, he'll let you. And he'll say, I will in no wise cast you out. So he takes Peter, James, and John. He goes into the mountain to pray. He's at Mount Hermon. He's alone in prayer. It looks like Jesus went there to pray. Why did he go there to pray? I told you he was just a few days from Calvary. Come on, and it may not sound like much to you, but when you know you're about to get beaten until you bleed, when you know they're about to nail your hands and nail your feet, when you know you're about to hang in the midnight sun in the heat and you're suffering and they have to give you benefit of the truth, when you know what's about to happen to you, you're going to pray. Oh, you better pray. Anybody in this room, when you go on these trials and trouble, you need to pray. Is there any time you need to pray when you're about to go through trials and hell and high water? You need somebody to comfort you. You need somebody to lift you up. And God is able. He's able to give you strength when you're weak. He's able to give you shelter when you're out there. We all need encouragement every now and then. Prayer. Verse 29, it says, let him pray. The fasting, his countenance began to change. Ghana became white. The kind of white that we can't even imagine. It's glistening white. And not only do we have this vision going on, but this Ghana, his glory, literally coming through. Not only is his glory beginning to show, but two fellows show up by the name of Moses and Elijah. You remember Moses, don't you? 40 years at Pharaoh's house, 40 years on the backside of the desert, and 40 years in the wilderness. God prepared Moses 80 years to do 40 years. I said, God prepared Moses for 80 years just to do 40 years of work. And we do that different nowadays. You spend 40 days in preparation to do 80 years of work. But Jesus spent more time in preparation than he actually did in doing the work. 30 years getting ready to do 3 years of work. And gives Moses 40 years thinking he was somebody. The next 40 years discovering he was a nobody. And then the next 40 years learning how God can use anybody. Yeah. Not only that, but he allowed the folks he was leading to get all his nerves. And God told him, speak to the rock, Moses, come to the rock. And I think I ought to say, don't let nobody take you this kick. Don't you get to the point where God has some blessings for you, you fool around and miss out on your thing. God said to Moses, I need to tell you, I'm not going to let you hear the promises, but I'm going to let you see. I'm going to let you take a look at it. Now, Elijah, he's a little different from us. Elijah had some faults himself. Remember, all of us have got some faults. But Elijah was a champ. Elijah was such a champ until one day he decided to be extraordinary. Elijah got the nerve to walk down to Ahab's house and pointed his little prophetic finger at Ahab and said, listen, the Lord, as the Lord lives, there shall be no dew or no rain until I give you word. Now, God didn't tell Elijah to do that. Now, but God honored what he said. And for 3 years and 6 months, there was no dew, no rain. What a champion Elijah was. But in spite of all that, He just wanted to hit a woman. Come on. My name was Jezebel.
The best was yet to come. Because a cloud came over.
that the voice came out of the fire. I said, the best was yet to come. God said, this is my beloved son, and you are well pleased. He was pleased because of Calvary. He was pleased because of the nails in his hands. He was pleased because of the ribbon in his feet. He was pleased because he died that Friday. I said, early Sunday morning, we got up a lot of power in his hand, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow.